Hello everyone. In this session, I'm going to explain the interview question. What is the purpose of using wrapper classes in Java? What is the purpose of using wrapper classes in Java? So guys, how to answer this question? What is the purpose of using wrapper classes in Java? How to answer this question? So I have given a step-by-step way of explaining this answer, guys. Let me get started with this. Okay. So you can start answering like this. All the things in Java are object-oriented in nature, but except the following primitive data types. What are the primitive data types, guys? Byte, short, int, long, float, double, char, boolean. These are all the primitive data types. All the things in Java are object-oriented in nature, except this primitive data types, except this listed down primitive data types. So Java have been using this non-object-oriented primitive data types with an intention of overcoming the performance issues which may occur by using objects for simple operations. So why Java can become 100% object-oriented programming language, right? Why Java is sticking to this primitive data types then? The main reason behind Java being sticking to this primitive data types is these are all the data types on which the simple operations will be performed. Okay, on all these data types, simple operations of Java will be taken care of. So if you make these things object oriented, so that will result in a performance issues. Okay, for the simple operations, if you use object oriented type data types, that may result in performance issues. To overcome this problem of performance issues which may raise by using objects as primitive, using primitive data types as objects, Java has avoided doing that. Okay, instead it kept primitive data types as non-object oriented only, to just to avoid performance issues which may occur from simple operations of this type of data types. Okay, so that's the reason behind why Java is not fully 100% object oriented and is sticking to primitive data types which are non-object oriented type, right? That's fine. Java for overcoming the performance issues is sticking to the primitive data types like this. That's fine, which are not object oriented. But how is this primitive data types concept related to wrapper classes? Okay, let me explain that second part. But there are some situations, guys. But there are some situations where we may have to use these primitive data types as objects. These are non-object oriented types. But there may be some situations while programming, guys, where we have to use these primitive data types as objects. Then only we can work on that programs. Otherwise, we cannot proceed. A blocker kind of situations may arise where primitive data types may not work. Okay. Until unless we convert these primitive data types into object oriented, then only we can continue with the program. Such kind of situations may arise. In that kind of situations, to overcome such kind of problem, Java has the following things known as wrapper classes. Okay, Java has a concept known as wrapper classes, using which all the primitive data types can be converted into the corresponding objects. Okay, so there may be some situations where primitive data types need to be used as objects. For such kind of situations, Java will allow you to use wrapper classes. With the help of these wrapper classes, we can convert these primitive data types into the corresponding objects. What are the wrapper classes, guys? What are the wrapper classes which we can use for with these primitive data types? Those are nothing but these things. They're all almost sound same, but the first letter will be capital, and for some of the data types, it will be longer text. Okay, here char is there, here character is there. Okay, here int is there, here integer is there, and also the first letter will change. Okay, for byte, small byte is there, here capital B, and remaining things are small, like that. Byte wrapper class. For short wrapper class. For int, integer wrapper class. For long wrapper class. For float wrapper class. For double wrapper class. For char, character wrapper class. For boolean wrapper class. Like this, for corresponding primitive data types, there are corresponding wrapper classes associated. Okay, I'll show you how the conversion will happen, how this wrapper classes can convert these primitive data types into objects. Okay, I'll explain that. Okay, let's say I'll create a variable a and declare it using the int data type. Okay, I'll assign a value known as 5 into this data type. Okay, now to convert this integer data type value 5 to a integer wrapper class. What I have to do? I have to create the wrapper class here, integer. Okay, for int, integer is the wrapper class, guys. Okay, integer, you can give anything. Integer I is equal to a. That's it, guys. Nothing more than that. Okay, just assign the value of a to the variable of integer wrapper class. Okay, you can do that. Now I is converted into integer. I is an object reference, guys. I is an object reference now. Okay, to the integer wrapper class. Here a is a variable, here I is the object type. Okay, we converted the value 5 into the object type. Now we can use it in some situations like this, guys. I cannot give the perfect situation for using this converted objects, but I will give you at least a basic example where the conversion is needed. For example, we have something known as collections framework, right? Array list in collections framework, like here we cannot store integer values. Okay, here we cannot store int values. Okay, here int is not allowed. For example, if I create something like this, it's not allowed, guys. Okay, I cannot create like this list int. This is not possible. Okay, you see some syntax error is coming. The problem here is collections framework or array list doesn't allow you to use primitive data type like int. In this situation, it only allows you to use integer wrapper class only. Okay, list of integer wrapper class is only allowed in this case as per the Java syntax. Now if I have to use this int here, I cannot pass it, right? Because it's a list of integer wrapper class elements, not list of int values. Now how to pass this int value into this integer list? That's not possible. So what I will do is I'll first convert it. Okay, int I is equal to 5, integer I is equal to a. Now I can use this. You see, I can now say list dot add of I. Like this I can use. Okay, it is a list of integer objects. It is a array list or list interface is a list of integer objects, not list of int values. Okay, int data type values. So this is where, guys, this is very basic place where I explained like the use of wrapper classes. But in real time, when advanced programming, there may be some situations where wrapper classes are really needed for converting these primitive data types into real world objects. Okay, corresponding objects, so that you can continue with your programming. This will be enough, guys. You can give these basic examples too. Okay, not a problem. So just it will add more value to your answer. So that's it, guys. Thank you. Bye.